Hey everybody, Dr. Kranke in the laboratory, making progress, very slow progress, but making progress nonetheless. I've got some stuff that I've been working on, but one of the things that I find fascinating about the rest of you guys doing your videos is that you keep chronicling what time and what date. So I don't know if I'm supposed to do it, but I'm going to do it. And there it is. All right. That's the time and the date. It's probably out of focus a little bit, but I'm sure you'll get it. Anyway, just getting some stuff in primer, the engine. And then something happened, which is that I opened this kit, this 1955 Chevy, the Revel. And I fell in love with it. It's a wonderful, absolutely wonderful kit. Love the way it looks. Love the size. So I decided to probably work on more than one, although I'm doing the one for the contest. But I think I'm going to do a couple more just to have them, because you can never have too many 55 Chevys. I'm going to show you the one for the contest I'm working on, primered. It's absolutely smooth, ready to go. I put the skirts on there, and I just removed a little bit of roughness around the basically the what do you call those things? You know, the thing that says the name. I sanded that down a little bit, but I didn't do anything else to it. So it's a great, great kit. I recommend it. And it's just in primer. I mean, it looks good enough to just be left by itself. And absolutely wonderful. Anyway, I also been working on mixing my own paint. This is going to be suede. So I'm using Auto Air colors. And this is what I've got right now. These are the colors I'm thinking of going with it. It's not going to be two-tone. It's going to be just one of these two blues. Now, this spoon right here is primer and then the color on top of it, and it came out a little bit too light. And the original color, as I mixed it, I was thinking of doing a coat over white, and so that's, I think that's the color I'm going to go with. Absolutely beautiful. Okay, and I think it's going to make the whole vehicle look pretty pretty nice. So I'm going with this. I mixed up enough of a batch so I won't run out at all, and I can do several coats. So I'm very excited about the fact that I got the right color for it. And that's it. That's what I've got so far. I've got the chassis set up and painted. It's actually, this is House of Color base coat with a flattening agent that House of Color has. Which is just called that flattening agent, which I mixed, I reduced, made it really thin. But this is a clear coat that when you spray over your base coat, it's just going to turn it. I mean, it's like absolutely beautiful. I did this yesterday, and I can already handle it, no problem. And it's got this wonderful flat tone to it, but it also has a nice feel to it. I don't know what it is, but it's pretty darn good. And so I'm excited. So I'm slowly making my way into the build and getting all the parts ready and stuff. So that's it. And speaking of parts, I mean, that's they're all in here. Okay, everything is in here, and I'm getting, you know, making progress and enjoying every minute of it. So I just wanted to say hello to everybody and wish everybody great luck on their build. I'm already seeing the videos. Wonderful. So stay energized, take your vitamins, and keep it going, because it's, you know, the clock is ticking, as they say. So keep having fun, and we'll touch base again in a couple of days. All right. Later.